Hi, I'm Roland Van Roy. I'd like to introduce the Richtek Load Transient Tool, a handy little tool that can be used to quickly check the stability of DC-DC converters like buck or boost converters, linear regulators, and even LED drivers.
You can check the stability of a voltage regulator by applying a fast load transient at the regulator output. The load transient generator consists of a MOSFET switch, a dynamic load resistor and a static load resistor, which is needed to keep the converter in continuous conduction mode operation. By measuring the load current and the converter output voltage, you can observe the load transient behavior of the converter. Transient response with smooth recovery indicates good control loop stability, which means sufficient phase margin. When a bump is observed, the phase margin is lower, but still okay. When significant bumps are seen, the phase margin may become marginal. And severe ringing in the waveform means low phase margin and poor control loop stability. The Richtek Load Transient Tool is specially designed to generate fast load steps for easy converter stability testing. It has an onboard microcontroller, a slew rate controlled MOSFET switch, 7 selectable dynamic load resistors and connection for a static load resistor. Load pulse duty cycle and frequency can be adjusted via push buttons, and a battery pack on the bottom side makes this tool fully isolated and portable. The load transient toolkit includes batteries and an adjustable power resistor for setting the static load. Let's test the stability of a 3.3-volt supply which uses RT7297C, an 800 kHz 3-amp current mode buck converter. I used the Richtek Designer online simulation tool to calculate circuit values. The circuit requires two 22 microfarad output capacitors, and the design tool predicts good stability with a control bandwidth of around 78 kHz. For the load transient stability test, we first need to select the static load and pulse load amplitude of the load generator. I normally set around 30% static load and 30% dynamic load, which keeps the regulator in continuous conduction mode. So for a 3.3 volt 3 amp supply, you would select around 3.6 ohm static load and 3.6 ohm dynamic load. First, adjust the 3.6 ohm static load via the adjustable power resistor, and then select the 3.3 ohm pulse load resistor via a jumper on the load transient tool. Then measure the converter output voltage near the output capacitors and measure the load current in the load transient tool leads. After switching on the load transient board, you can now see the converter transient response on the oscilloscope. The smooth waveform indicates good stability. But you can learn more from this measurement. By measuring the step load response time of a current mode buck converter, which is the time from step load start to the point where the converter starts to recover, you can estimate the bandwidth or unity gain frequency of the control loop. In this case, I measured around 4.6 microseconds response time, and the bandwidth can be calculated by 0.3 divided by 4.6 microseconds, which gives 65 kHz. As we normally set the control bandwidth of a current mode buck converter below 10% of the switching frequency, the 65 kHz measured bandwidth is a reasonable value for an 800 kHz converter. When I compared these results with an actual open loop gain phase measurement using a network analyzer, I measured a phase margin of 55 degrees and a control bandwidth of 60 kHz. So my simple measurement with the load transient tool was actually pretty close. Current mode buck converter stability problems are often related to the converter output capacitance value. Here is an example what happens when you change the original two larger 22 microfarad 25 volt output capacitors into two smaller 22 microfarad 6.3 volt types. You now see that the step response shows severe ringing, which means low phase margin. The converter response time has reduced to 2.6 microseconds, so the converter bandwidth has increased to around 115 kHz, which is really high for an 800 kHz converter. The reason for the poor stability is the reduction of the output capacitance. a 22 microfarad 6.3 volt 0805 size MLCC capacitor has only 11 microfarad at 3.3 volt DC bias, and will drop another 28% due to its low AC ripple in the buck application. So we end up with totally 16 microfarad effective output capacitance instead of the original 44 microfarad design value. This lower output capacitance increases the modulator pole frequency, and the open loop unit gain frequency will increase to a point where the phase margin is lower. This also explains why we measured a higher bandwidth with the fast transient measurement. To get stable performance again, you can either increase the output capacitance or reduce the compensator gain to reduce the unity gain frequency. In this example, I chose to reduce the compensator gain by reducing the compensator resistor in the same ratio as the output capacitance drop. You now see stable performance again, and the response time measurement shows that the bandwidth has dropped to 61 kHz, which is a good target value for this converter.
I hope this example has given you an idea of what you can do with the load transient tool. Please note that different converter types have different stability criteria. The documentation that comes with the tool includes links to design tips and application notes with more information how to test DC-DC converter applications with the load transient tool.
The Richtek load transient tool is available at Farnell, Element 14 and DigiKey. If you are often working with DC-DC converters, I highly recommend to get this handy little tool for your lab testing.